Howdy! Welcome to the Texas A&M AgriLife Research and Extension Center at Dallas.
Turfgrasses are part of people's everyday lives, from home lawns, around office buildings, public parks, golf courses, and other sports fields, providing safe and inviting playing surfaces for our children and athletes.
A main focus of our turfgrass breeding program is to develop cultivars that are stress tolerant and require lower inputs of water and pesticides.
Texas A&M AgriLife Research is the curator of one of the world's largest zoysia grass germplasm collections, used by the turfgrass breeding program to make crosses.
I am Ambika Chandra.
I am Dennis Genovese.
Megan Meeks.
I'm Tianyi Wang.
Justin Eads.
I am Esti Kong.
Martin Guerrero Rojas.
Sandy Wisdorf.
And we are the turfgrass breeding program at Texas A&M AgriLife Research and Extension Center in Dallas.
A major initiative in our program is to improve drought resistance in warm season turfgrasses in order to better prepare the turfgrass industry for reoccurring cycles of drought.
We have pioneered the use of embryo rescue technology to break ploidy barriers in St. Augustine grass, and we've developed hybrids that require over 50% less water than commercially available industry standards. We are excited about these developments, and we believe that this will result in significant cost and water savings as these hybrids become commercially available. We also work to improve cold tolerance in C4 warm season turf grasses and move their range of adaptation into the transition zone, where cool season grasses can suffer from heat stress. In collaboration with Kansas State University, Texas A&M AgriLife Research has released an interspecific and cold-tolerant cultivar of zoysia grass named Innovation, now being produced on 34 sod farms in 15 states. Innovation zoysia grass was specifically developed to reduce water, pesticide, and nutrient usage, so it offers a sustainable alternative for golf course fairways, tees, and home lawns in the transition zone. Our program also develops turf grasses for sports and playing surfaces. The program's interspecific zoysia grass hybrid LAZER, for example, is perfect for golf course putting greens. With its dwarf canopy height, dark green genetic color, high shoot density, excellent fall color retention, and shade tolerance.
Reduced growth rate of LAZER zoysia grass means less frequent mowing, less nutritional requirements, which makes it a budget-friendly alternative to cultivars and species that are commonly used on putting surfaces.
We also seek to improve tolerance to large patch disease and southern chinch bugs, and we work to understand the physiological responses of turf grasses under varying levels of shade.
Our breeding objectives are driven by consumer and industry needs. We utilize traditional plant breeding methods as well as tools of molecular biology and genetic engineering in our program.
Molecular marker and DNA sequencing technology can assist us in selecting plants and trees by genotyping. This technology also allows us to understand the molecular mechanism underlying the important abiotic and biotic traits.
At the same time, unmanned aerial systems and sensor technologies help us collect geospatial data at higher frequencies and finer spatial and temporal scales.
In my perspective, integration of turfgrass genomics with sensor-based high-throughput phenotyping technologies provide us with opportunities to potentially accelerate the plant breeding process and make it more efficient.
At the same time, we rely on collaboration with seed and sod industries to evaluate prospective cultivars for all aspects of production viability and provide outreach for consumers.
Valued partnerships with our turfgrass industry, world-class research facilities and team, large germplasm collections, public and private funding to our program, allow us to continue turfgrass innovations for the benefit of society and the environment.